We're going to talk about the music in a little bit, but I got to ask something. How important is this, the look? I mean, I don't know. Is there a way you would describe, I mean, I hate to use the word image, but you guys have a certain image, a certain look. Is there a way you would describe the white zombie look or image?
Well, it's our whole sort of look sort of backfired, and this is what happened. Mm-hmm. We had this Afro thing going. Didn't work. It's sort of like a Quiet Riot stretch pants deal, you know?
Didn't work, so you kind of took a little bit of everything.
Yeah, we just sort of, however we fall out of bed, we said, damn it, that's the best we're ever gonna look.
And so this is the way you fall out of bed. Sometimes you wear the blue hairy jacket. So now talk about the music. The music is definitely something different. I don't like to use comparisons, but I mean, you remind me a little bit of Zodiac Mind Warp, which was a band that I dug a lot. And the Beatles. But have you heard the Zodiac? Anybody's ever? Nobody?
Yeah, we heard.
You're saying no. I was saying, oh, maybe
no,
just me.
That was a band
I was a big fan of. And I mean, you kind of remind me a little bit of that because, it's fun
it's
stuff.
The shoes.
It's the shoes. But I mean, you don't have that much of it. It's not like real serious political stuff. It's poking fun at a lot of stuff, right?
It's poking fun.
I mean, Spider Baby, yeah. That's not going to change the world.
No.
Well, that's actually about saving the rainforest.
And Knuckle Duster?
The whale song.
Welcome to Planet Mother. I can't really say that one on MTV. Why don't we take a look at a video
planet.
From them? Why don't you tell us a little bit about this song, Thunderkiss?
It's just your basic story. Fabulous babes cracking the spines of jocular he guys, you know,
so it's
in
very,
the desert.
Very serious stuff.
Forget about it.
Let's play. Here's a white zombie with Thunderkiss.
Oh, yeah.
Right on. Oh, sorry. I was just commenting on the drawings on the back of the album cover, and you were just telling me that you did some of this stuff.
Yeah.
It's real wild.
Edit all that.
Kind of reminds me of the old Hot Rod stuff. And
yeah, like Big Daddy Roth.
Exactly.
Nonsense.
I'm a
yeah.
big fan of all that
Oh, really?
Stuff. Yeah.
Cool.
Now, on the Headbangers Ball, we have segments like Frantic Fringe, Triple Thrash Threat. And when we first played your video, we played it in the Frantic Fringe because we really had no idea where to what to call a band like White Zombie, which is good.
Good.
I mean, it's
yeah.
not, you know, you can see a band and say, oh, this is your typical heavy metal band, but you're definitely not your typical band. What would be a type of music category that you say you would fall under? And I can't wait to hear this band. But think of a good one.
Sort of like an old school disco fusion deal we're working on.
Metal disco
yeah,
fusion.
You know. Right Said Fred thing. Really slick.
I noticed that.
I'm afraid we're too sexy for your show.
Psychedelic, satanic thing.
Uh-huh. What's kind of some of the stuff that you're listening to?
Oh, no. a lot of old 60s surf music, and I like the Butthole Surfers, and a lot of different
you
stuff.
Say butthole.
Can we
said
say
his
that
wife,
word?
So I guess we'll find out.
All kinds of stuff.
Uh-huh. Now, on the video Thunderkiss, which we just saw, you guys go pretty wild on it. Is that kind of what the show is like, live?
Yeah, we, you know, get ants in our pants.
That's kind of when I'm asking a question. I'm just sitting here waiting, sitting here going, I can't wait to hear what this answer is.
Stupid answer is going to say no.
We're going to talk to White Zombie, find out more interesting stuff when we get back. But right now, let's play a video from Ugly Kid Joe. Here is Madman with Rob and Sean from White Zombie. And does anybody ever say anything, you being a female bass player, does that ever get tough?
No, not at all. Actually, people usually think I'm a guy on stage.
So. I doubt that.
What's
no,
the really wimpy guy in the band?
It still happens. I don't know. So that's never been a problem.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, listening to your record, you take little bits and pieces from a lot of old B movies. What are some of the movies? And have you been sued for that yet?
Almost.
Not yet.
Is not as far as Geffen knows. Things like High School Confidential and Dawn of the Dead. And
Faster Pussycat, Kill
yeah.
Kill, a lot of Russ Meyer movies.
Mm-hmm. Star Trek bits and pieces, and a lot of it's real. A lot of it's real radio stuff.
Were you a fan of like a lot of those B movies type thing?
Oh yeah,
still are. Mm-hmm. Now the album is called La. Let me see if I pronounce. You pronounce it.
I think that's your job.
La Sexorcisto Devil Music Volume 1. So the next one would be Devil Music Volume 2.
Yes. No, I don't know. If there's another one.
A six
see how
volume
this one
set.
Sells.
Now I hear you guys are going out on the road pretty soon.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're leaving.
Tell us about it, would you?
Well, we're going out with my sister's machine.
Great band.
Yeah, in about a couple days. I don't know.
And the tour starting here in New York?
Yep.
Yeah. You're kind of the bi-coastal band now, right? You're from New York.
Hey, wait
you've been
a minute.
Hey. No, that means living on two different coasts. Because you lived in New York. I know you've been living in L.A. for about 6 months or so.
Yeah, because, you know, we were broke, so we went to L.A. because you can live for free.
Really? That I didn't know either.
Oh, come on now. Find some rock and roll girl, they pay for everything.
Yeah.
You know that scam.
Sure.
I had a hard time, but...
Well, good luck with everything, and definitely check out White Zombie on the Road. I heard the record. I like the record. I haven't seen you live, but I guarantee I will.
Cool.
Go hook up some of your shows. Be fun.
Grooving.
And good luck with everything.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks.
Still on the way, we've got the Frantic Fringe, a segment that White Zombie has appeared in before. And in the Frantic Fringe, we've got a debut from Godflesh with a song called Motra. And I'm sure you know where Motra comes from.
Hell yeah. No.
You don't? I would think you know. Motra was one of those characters in the Godzilla movie.
Oh. Motra.
I would think they would know that. Stick around. Headbangers Ball continues.
And as our guests continue on the Headbangers Ball, right now we're joined with Rob from White Zombie. How you doing, Rob?
All right.
We talked to you when the album just came out, right, which is called Devil Music Volume 1 or La Sexorcisto.
Yeah.
How'd I do on the pronunciation? Is right. Are you working on Devil Music Volume 2?
No.
But you are working on a new album?
No. We have no songs.
This is going to be, so get this, if this is going to be...
You may never write another song.
The White Zombie Anthology right here, and first album, all in one.
So
how things have changed since the album's been out?
How have it changed?
Been playing a lot more.
Yeah, right with Pantera.
Uh-huh. That's got to be a pretty energetic show.
Yeah, it's cool. Those guys got a lot of money to throw around, so...
Yeah. And they're giving you the big bucks, boys. So that's why it's good, right?
We get to share
making
all of it.
Making the big bucks,
yeah.
The mansions and limos coming
well,
up
Well, they bring their cars and their motorcycles and cruise around.
Right. So the album's out, and in a little bit later, we're going to play the video for Black Sunshine. And Iggy Pop is in the video, as well as doing kind of like the little words part of the song. How'd that work out? I mean, is Iggy Pop a fan of White Zombies, or you're a fan of his? And...
We're a fan of his. I guess he likes us enough to be in the video, so.
Or do you have to pay him the big bucks, too?
No. I don't know, probably.
Okay, we're going to be playing, like I said, Black Sunshine, and we'll be talking to Rob from White Zombie after this. Here with Rob from White Zombie, and we were talking a little bit that you're out on the road with Pantera, which is a good show, but you guys are two totally different styles, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. A lot less hair in that band.
A lot less hair in that band.
They're a little chubbier.
Are you still bringing the big, kind of like cut-out monster type things?
No, nah.
Had to leave those.
Not
the dramatic stage show this time.
No, we're bored with it.
Yeah, now we're a little bit later. We're going to be playing the video for Black Sunshine, which I named my motorcycle after hearing the song. I had to name it, so it's called Black Sunshine, which is something of absolutely no value to anybody. But tell me a little bit about the video. It's a different looking video than Thunder Kiss.
Yeah. We had even less money to make this one, so we went out and...
So it's not going for quality right now. It's kind of an economic
quantity
type video, right?
Not quality. Yeah, we went out to Chicago and found some farmhouse and ran around and lit stuff on fire and just filmed it. And then they knocked it down the next day.
And now, is this tour with Pantera, is this your first national tour?
We were out with Testament for a while before Pantera.
Now I understand that you're going to be going to Europe. A matter of fact, you're playing with Danzig, and we're going to be there in Germany when you guys are with our Dirty Black Summer thing in Germany. Have you ever played Europe before?
Yeah, a couple of years ago. Went over there for a couple months or so.
I'm pretty excited to get back out there now that the album's out.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to the cheese sandwiches every day.
And the great food.
Yeah.
You from Exodus. I'm an Exodus fan. The last Exodus album, I gotta be honest, I thought it was okay. This new Exodus album is great. I definitely recommend it. I like the song a lot. And they've already got a bunch of new videos that we're gonna be showing up, coming up on the ball in future episodes that are already done. But this is a new one. This is a debut from Exodus. This is killer. It's called Thorn in My Side. Back here with Rob from White Zombie, and we were talking about how you guys are out on the road with Pantera. And is it fun seeing people, you know, reaction now? Because like the last time when we talked to you, like I said, the album was just out. And now you've got the reaction that people have heard the records a lot.
It's cool to play and people know the songs. Because when we first went out, you know, the record's out a week.
Uh-huh.
It's like one guy. Now it's cool. Yeah.
Right. Because it seems like, I mean, a lot of places I go to, like if I'm wearing a White Zombie shirt or something like that, people are into the band. And
yeah, people seem to be picking up on it.
Girls like to dance to it. Sort of. Yes? No? No comment?
Maybe.
Yeah. Lighten up.
I don't know.
You can throw a comment in anywhere. About to play White Zombie's Black Sunshine. And before we play it, is there anything you'd like to say about the video?
Well, it's kind of funny because we filmed it all over the place because we couldn't get the schedule down. So Iggy's in New York, and we never actually saw Iggy while we filmed it. We were in Chicago, and the live stuff is from L.A. or somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
We just kind of filmed all these pieces and threw it together.
So Iggy Pop on typewriter.
It pretty much worked. Yep. Iggy's banging on the typewriter.
Okay, well, let's take a look. Here is Black Sunshine. They just won't leave. We've got Phil and Rob both here right now. Now tell us if you can tell us some interesting tour stories from these Pantera White Zombie troops now that both of you guys are here.
Funniest thing one night, man. He had this cup of water, and he spilled it all over himself. God, it was funny.
You guys are wacky.
God, that's
spilling
just,
water and everything.
Spill water.
It gets pretty, nutty.
One time we yelled at him real loud.
No.
God,
you guys
insane.
Do some nutty kind of things. I heard one time on the tour you guys stayed up just all night, just for the heck of it.
We didn't sleep twice.
These guys are wacky. What crazy things. You hear about crazy stuff like that happening
and in rock and roll. Happen.
And it
happens.
To find out that it actually happens
the
is amazing.
The funniest thing is, all the people. Hey man, Phil, Robin, can we get backstage, man? We're thinking to ourselves, man, what is so special about backstage? You Vince. Sit there, Vince.
Vince. You know what the thing is? What is so special? They want to get close to you two, and now that I'm
our
here,
underwear.
I don't
you
know what's so special
about it
either.
You can't wait to get away from us. Yeah.
You smell it? You check my breath out? Jesus
garlic.
Christ, all these avocados.
Angel hair puffs.
Good
garlic.
We're going to find out more interesting stuff as we talk to Phil and Rob from Pantera and White Zombie. And when we come back, we're going to be playing a video from Life, Sex, and Death, or abbreviated LSD. And we've got the new Motorhead video, Hellraiser, all that and much more. As Chuck Willery said, we'll be back in 2 and 2.
Oh.
Somewhat serious side. New videos. You've got a new one coming up?
Same cat who did Black Sunshine, did our new one. Walk.
Looks like
exactly
that song.
The same.
Good song.
It looks just the same. Both lead singers are, you know, doing that.
Rock and roll thing.
That thing, you know, fist and stuff, you know. But actually, we decided to skip out on all this concept stuff because we're no good at it, man. None of us can act or anything. We left it basic live video, man.
None of the standing in the cemetery.
Though. Yeah, praying
the,
to
God,
stone
the
idols or whatever
thing.
The hell. You know, we're not
Jesus.
Into it. Yeah.
Remember that?
Shut up. Anyway, it's just basic, flat-out documentary-looking live, I guess. I haven't seen any footage from it, but I'm just making it
but
up.
But so you've been told. So. And you guys had one of my probably favorite home videos out a while ago.
Now, not to confuse anybody, we're putting out two separate videos. One's going to be just the videos and stuff that we did in Russia. And then we're going to put out the home movie, which is going to be horse crap. I mean, it's just filled with...
The Russian stuff is on the home video.
If you mix this up, if somebody hand me a knife, I'm killing him.
Because you have some on the other one, got like a lot of the radio stuff and like the thing in Colorado that we did.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. All that
many
stuff.
Years.
See, we're gonna put all this garbage on the home movie, which is going to be long this time around. Probably, you know, good 15 minutes long. No, actually, it's going to be about 2 hours long. It's just going to be full of crap, man.
It's going to be
expensive.
People
love to see. It's going to be real expensive, and we hope to sell somewhere in the range of
dozens.
You know, dozens.
When we come back, we'll try to find out what kind of stuff that Rob is going to do for videos, or maybe he'll just try to figure out what to do with the two Pantera videos. But here's I'm a tank, from Life, Sex, and Death. We're here with Phil and Rob, and now we're going to ask you, what are your big video plans? Do you have any kind of great
stories
to
tell about?
Yeah,
we're making a home video.
Yeah, it's only one,
well,
though.
It's just backstage of the stuff of them filming their home video, so it's going to be good, right? No.
Yeah, no.
Nothing goes on backstage. All their backstage stuff is funny. It's all staged.
It's fake.
It doesn't really. It doesn't happen.
It's like you've got the show on stage, and then you've got the show,
and then
just for
right.
the fans,
and then
backstage,
you know,
to
the
show them how crazy
drill.
Rock and roll
well,
is.
Vince spits blood through. I mean, Vince, you know, spits.
But he
blood.
Does that at home.
You know, Daryl
bleeding
G.G. Allin the other night.
Though. Yeah,
that's the truth.
What's a G.G. Allin, or shouldn't we ask on MTV?
He defecated on stage.
Oh, you know what?
What?
I actually heard that.
It's,
so
yeah,
I know you're
true,
telling the truth.
Unfortunately.
What a wacky guy.
Way too close for
wacky guy.
But the thing is, actually, someone told me that, so I heard that story
no
one is
seem
true.
To notice.
Should we tell him about Vince and the TV?
Yeah.
Tell him.
He's your drummer.
They're probably watching the show right now. And
it's okay.
They're
going like to
be mad at you, not me, so go ahead. Tell me your story.
I wasn't there. Ah, drummers.
Yeah.
We get a new drummer. That's new. Yeah, we threw out our drummer.
How come?
Eh.
Who's the new drummer?
Because drummers,
that's just
want to get rid
thing.
Of them just for the fun of
so
it.
So tell us about the new drummer.
He's all right. What do you think?
I like Follow. Yeah, man. His actual name is Phil, but you know, since there's two Phils, you can't.
More wacky confusion.
Philo.
I say Phil. He
great.
Looks.
Used
I don't
play,
even want.
He used to play with Last Crack.
But don't hold that against.
No, don't hold that against. You know, okay. Don't you ever say that. Anyway, you know, Grooves, man. This cat Grooves. He's in.
Well, you'll see the new drummer is really
and all
thick.
The wacky things they're doing, like spilling water and maybe even what Daryl did. When the Pantera White Zombie show comes to your town, thanks for stopping by. Right now it's time for the last video, a band that you went on tour before with, Suicidal Tendencies. Here's Asleep at the Wheel.
And now you're out on the road playing your own shows.
Yeah.
With Monster Magnet opening up.
You could say that.
Some of them. Show's going good.
Yeah, it's great. It's cool.
Yeah, I've seen them a couple of the shows and definitely suggest you checking them out. And towards the ending of the March, they're going to be all around the West Coast. I know you're playing at the Ventura Theater sometime like March 28th or 29th. I'm not exactly sure.
Something like that.
If he finishes the wall, hey, he'll be there. But right now, let's play a video. Anything you want to say about this video?
Is it our video or is it someone else's?
It's yours. It's Black Sunshine.
You know, that it's black and white and there's some nice, well, in the live footage, you can see our new drummer checking out our old drummer because that's the show he came to see that he would be replacing him. Of course, the old drummer didn't know that at the time, but the new drummer was there to replace him.
You might see the look of nervousness
on his face.
But it's
in the video. It's a wacky world, isn't it? Right?
It's crazy and kooky. And here is White Zombie with Black Sunshine. Connecticut, and she asks, what was the best show that I ever taped? My favorite guest has got to be Brian Johnson from AC/DC, who I was excited about meeting and ended up being very cool. And also, always like taping shows with Ozzy. And of course, Rob from White Zombie, of course. How could I forget? Also asks, who plays the music at the beginning of and end of the Headbangers Ball? Well, that must be Pantera. And a matter of fact, it's funny that you ask about Pantera because we're about to play a video from Pantera. And I would also like to tell you that they're about to embark on a tour with Sacred Reich. So there is a killer double bill. And Rob's even been on the road with Pantera.
Believe it or else.
Anyways, right now, here is Pantera with This Love. That was Collision with Chains. And this is Rob Zombie, and he's still painting, and got the devil thing going, got the
eyeball,
cocktail olive,
cocktail wiener,
hard-boiled egg. Got a letter. This letter comes from Simone Poteet from Nine Mile Point, California, I think. She asked if I enjoyed working with Guns N' Roses on the November Rain video, which was, I had a blast. And do I plan to do any more videos? Well, they're not banging on my door asking me to. And are Ozzy, Randy, Zach, and Mike as nice off camera as they are on camera? Yeah, they're actually very cool guys, and I've always had a good time working with Ozzy Osbourne. Anyway, we'll be back with the Headbangers Ball, last video of the night. We get tons of letters here on the Headbangers Ball, and if you want to write to us, here is the address. MTV Networks, care of Headbangers Ball, 1515 Broadway, 24th floor. New York, New York, 10036. A lot of you writing Wicked, hope you dug it, and I hope you dug tonight's show. And remind you, every Saturday night is Headbangers Ball, starting off at 11 with Countdown to the Ball, and then the Headbangers Ball. And our guest next Saturday on the Headbangers Ball is going to be Mike Muir of Infectious Grooves and Suicidal Tendency, and someone that knows even more about hockey than I do. And, oh, I got a new tattoo I wanted to show you. This is the latest one. It's the Elvis stamp. And this is from Greg James from Sunset Strip Tattoo. See? Thank you very much. Thank you. Little sneer. Treat me like a fool. It's definitely time to end this show. It's time for me to Zombie stop painting and go back out on the road. Go check out White Zombie. They are currently on the road. And on various occasions, we will steal him and let him finish our wall. And thank you. Thank you, Rob. Thank you so much for painting. And thank you again for watching. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We're going to run the credits. We're going to let Rob paint. I'm going to go to sleep because I need it. Remember to keep one foot in the gutter, one fist in the goal. Bye. In the movie Singles, and the movie Singles is out on home video, and it is the director's cut, which I don't know if that means it's longer or whatever it means, but the movie was real good. Cameron Crowe film, and if you didn't see it in the theaters, you might want to check it out, and you can see little cameos from some of your favorite Seattle bands.
Now don't move, because coming up in just a little bit, we've got some killer videos from Queensryche, AC/DC, The Cult, Nine Inch Nails, and a new band featuring Stephen Piercy, formerly of Rat, and Fred Corey, formerly of Cinderella. The band is called Arcade, and we're going to see a video from them. Also, Testament is going to be here in just a little bit. And we've got Rob Zombie,
hey,
lead vocalist of that swing and rock band White Zombie, and also quite a kooky artist. So how's the art thing coming along?
Horrible. Look for yourself.
It looks really good.
As
you can see,
crap.
This is some of Rob's work, and buy his record. And we're going to talk to Rob about painting and other stuff and watch him paint and all that kinds of stuff later, but it's looking real.
Plug in.
Dave is taking
our Headbangers Ball. We've got another one of our action-packed segments with our man in the street, my Brooklyn brother, Dominic, who was actually supposed to be here right now to help introduce this segment, but of course it's Saturday night and he's probably got something to do. And speaking of somebody that doesn't have anything to do on a Saturday night, Rob Zombie is painting on a Saturday night. Real quick, tell me what's up with White Zombie.
Absolutely nothing. We're off the road. Our life sucks.
And
we're intending to write new songs, but we all hate each other now, so we can't accomplish anything.
So basically, you've resorted to painting to get on Headbangers Ball right
exactly.
now.
Exactly. It works like a charm.
It's worked four times.
I don't do anything new. No new music, no new videos, and here I am every week.
See that? There you go. If only
brilliant.
I could paint. Anyway, we've got some new videos from Living Color and Kiss, who, by the way, will be special guests on the ball June 5th. You heard it right. Kiss are going to be special guests on the Headbangers Ball June 5th. And I will be here too, and it'll be a lot of fun. Right now, if you haven't heard, there's a band out there called Arcade. Stephen Piercy's in it. Fred Curry's in it. They've got a video called Nothing to Lose, and it goes something like this. You crazy people out there. You know what it means? I just threw green paint all over the place. Rob, why don't you tell us the guests that are going to be on the Headbangers Ball next Saturday?
The Quick Assault and the Nuclear Sand Guys.
More Nuclear Assault and Quicksand.
Exactly.
And all of this crazy, kooky stuff.
Don't forget the countdown. You know, he reads everything off his book.
All of it. And right there,
it
says right there,
goodbye.
He reads all of this. None of it is spontaneous. See, I need help with that word spontaneous. So, anyway, it all kicks off Countdown to the Ball next Saturday at 11 p.m., 10 Central. And I'm going to finish...
I dig your chair, man.
Rob's, really?
It's freaking my trip.
Dude, and I dig your wacky, kooky paintings. Rob from White Zombie, you out on the road anytime soon?
No way, man.
How about a new album?
Freak my trip.
How about a new album?
No way, bro.
How about any art exhibits?
I ain't doing nothing. It's coming to your barbecue.
Well, there you go.
I'll bring
you
a dip.
I'll see you next Saturday. Remember to keep one foot in the gutter, one fish in the gold. Bye.
Bye.
The all-involved Rob Zombie sitting here and painting very, very slowly. It guarantees us mentioning White Zombie on Headbangers Ball. Nuclear Assault is also going to be here when the Headbangers Ball continues, so stay tuned. Zombie with Thunderkiss, and I've been doing the Headbangers Ball here for about 3.5 years now, and probably the most blatant way I've ever seen of getting something played on Headbangers Ball was to offer your talents to paint a wall for us and make sure that it takes about 4 or 5 months to do it, so you're just always on the Headbangers Ball, such is the case with Mr. Rob Zombie, our artist here.
Now just walk over here.
So tell me, Rob, who came up with the idea of you taking 4 months to paint something so you could be on Headbangers Ball, just about as much as I am?
I think it was that Cindy Crawford came up with the idea.
I heard you did some painting for Cindy.
Yeah.
Which one of these characters is her favorite piece?
He hates all of them.
I'll tell you which
He's
Cindy's
totally
favorite piece is. But right now, it's time for us to play something from a band who will be my co-host on June 5th. I do know you dig this band.
Right on.
Kiss.
Yeah.
Big Kiss fan.
Yeah.
See Kiss live in the old days?
No, because I was only in third grade, man.
Oh, that's right. We do that age thing. That's right. When Kiss first played, I was only like 3 years old. Here is Kiss with I Love It Loud. By the way, June 5th, they're going to be co-hosts on the show. True, they can't paint, but we'll have them on anyway. Here is Kiss. Because when the Headbangers Ball continues, we've got the latest from Grunt Truck. It's called Crazy Love, and it's coming up in just a little bit. Hey, thanks a lot for spending your Saturday night with us here at the Headbangers Ball. I would like to thank the band Quicksand and Nuclear Assault for stopping by. I'd like to thank Dom, our man in the street, and want to remind you that Dom and myself will be your guys in the club when we do that Anthrax thing, so look for us, come up and say hi. Also would like to thank Rob Zombie, who is finishing up his painting that's taken about 4 months or so. Thank you, Rob. Does this look wonderful? You have to beg for applause here on the Headbangers Ball. Anyway, if you've got something you want to say or you want to write or make any comments or suggestions, please do. We get lots of letters, and I read every one. Right to Headbangers Ball, care of MTV Net. Right now, it's time to roll out the last video of the night. Here's a debut from Grunt Truck. This is Crazy Love. That was Grunt Truck with Crazy Love. Want to thank you for spending your Saturday night here. And I want to thank Quicksand. I want to thank Nuclear Assault. Want to thank Rob Zombie for staying here and painting the walls, spending many, many weeks, and also made it able for us to talk about White Zombie every week. So since you're done painting now, please tell us what is up with White Zombie.
Well, that's
plug
funny.
Something.
You should ask me.
Plug something, Rob. The real reason you're here.
Oh, May 15th, Phoenix. Big show, us, Sepultura, Suicidal, bunch of people that I can't remember.
Flotsam Jetsam. Think they're on it. Huh?
Spontaneously ask me.
Because I wanted to go.
You know more about it than me.
But there, go see White Zombie live. I've seen them several times, and out of all the bands I've seen, White Zombie is one of them. Be here next week for the official Headbangers Ball Barbecue. Kicks off your early start to summer, and it'll take place at my house. And I wish you could be there, Rob. I truly
I'll
do.
I'll be there.
Will you bring the weenies?
No.
Rob will be there, and he's going to be taking other people's weenies. Everything starts off with Countdown to the Ball at 11 p.m. 10 Central.
Those
be
weenies.
There next Saturday. Everything starts off with Countdown to the Ball at 11 p.m. 10 Central. Be there next Saturday. It's going to be fun. I had a blast. Again, thanks for watching. Remember to keep one foot in the gutter, one fist in the gold. Bye. With the guys in White Zombie, this guy we've talked to probably every episode for the past month now.
So I'm never coming. I'm here again.
And I love your summer attire.
Don't start.
Well, everybody's been dogging on my shirt. You don't think I look like Tom Selleck in this shirt? Maybe more like Connie Selica. Connie Selica. Anyways, so what do you have planned for this summer?
What's your type of summer thing?
We hate the summer.
I would imagine a lot of surfing.
We would never go to a barbecue if there weren't TV cameras.
Yeah, that's good. Then how would they know?
Right,
anyway?
Phil likes free food, so he's there.
Yeah, I'm here for the food.
I like how you got here 2 hours before everyone else.
Of course. First in line for those ribs.
The one thing you can say about Phil, he's very punctual. Very punctual.
Say a few other things.
I know if everybody would agree.
We'd have to refilm the segment.
So do you have any wacky, crazy, kind of kooky summer plans?
No.
Stay indoors as much as possible until night when it gets down to about 80 degrees.
Keep the sun off the bod.
Phil's not really into kooky plans.
No. Okay. We will be working on some new White Zombie stuff.
Oh, yeah. We got so many songs, right?
I could see that you guys were all, like, sitting there with your little pad of paper not too long ago.
Yeah.
Sketching down, because you had a lot of, like, inspiration from this summery barbecue type thing.
A lot of shorts here.
Yes, there are
short
a lot of shorts.
We really
and Hawaiian shirts. Actually, no, there's only one Hawaiian shirt, and it's mine.
Shorts.
We'll be back with more Headbangers Ball and more people making fun of my shirt. So stay tuned. That was Goddess hanging out with Sean from White Zombie. We've had Rob hanging out with us for about a month. And so tell me what's up with White Zombie. What's up with you guys?
Oh, man.
And girl.
I guess we're back here in L.A. working on a new record, mainly. Just trying to write a lot of songs. Hopefully we're going to record it over the summer, get it out for the fall.
Now, there's a couple questions that I never wanted to ask you, and I never have asked you, but I'm probably going to ask anyway. You know that you're like... How is it? You're the girl in the band, aren't you?
I get so many people in, and they're like, oh, it's a band with four guys. I'm like,
well, you know what it is? If people haven't seen you play heavy. I mean, I know that there's people like... But when we were looking for bass players, we were going, I'd like to find a guy that could play as heavy as Sean. I mean, you don't play, not to put down you girl musicians, but you're like...
I know what you're saying. No,
you know what I mean?
Thanks, I appreciate it. That's cool.
I mean, does that kind of stuff happen? Do people think, oh, like, I mean, you don't look like a guy?
All the time.
But,
all
really?
The time. We found a personal ad in the LA Weekly that's like, a guy plays to thinking I was a guy. Like, I was guy seeking same sex. And I said, are you bass player for White Zombie? I want to meet you, blah, blah, blah. So all this stuff. And, no, it's ridiculous, though. People still think I'm a guy, but whatever. It's all right.
We're going to play a video right now from Judas Priest, and we'll be back with more Headbangers Ball from my backyard. And now we're hanging out with Rob and Phil. Like, you didn't even know, you didn't know this was Rob. If you've watched the show in the past five shows, you've probably seen this guy in about
three of them from White Zombie. And I just wanted to show you one thing. If these guys don't show up, it doesn't matter. See this? This is the entire White Zombie concert, right? Right here.
Mm-hmm.
Just so you know, I'm joking. People might believe it. People might believe it. How the show's been going? First of all, congratulations. I mean,
thanks.
Overnight sensations, huh?
Yeah. Thanks for having us on, finally.
Overnight sensations. These guys is just like, I don't know. I mean, how long has the record been out? You know, you're standing right in front of this guy right here.
Excuse me.
See that? We talked to Rob too much. Later. Ah, but it doesn't matter. Anyways, the record has been out how long now?
2-3 weeks.
So it's been out about, what, a year and a half? 2 years?
See,
he gives these smart-ass answers, and I already know the answer, so he can just give a smart-ass answer, and it's like I don't even have to ask him. So how long has the record been out?
3 M&Ms, that's how long it's been out.
It's been out almost about 2 years.
Now we get 3 M&Ms.
You know what, we're going to play the video. We're going to talk to everybody else in the band, try to get a straight answer, because now due to the success of White Zombie, because of Beavis and Butthead, is why these guys are doing so good. It has nothing to do with us playing them on the Headbangers Ball, with us trying to get White Zombie on as many times as we want, me lying my butt off saying how much I love this band. Then they start selling records, and it's all owed to two cartoon characters.
Exactly.
Right now, let's go to Countdown to the Ball. Number 4 has nothing to do with it being on the countdown.
Next
it's because
be
of Beavis Butthead. No, next
4,
week it'll be number.
Pay him more money.
That's right. Keep
Man,
these checks going. Keep the
3.
M&Ms coming. Here's Thunderkiss from White Zombie. They're about to play tonight, where they are going to be out on the road with Anthrax and with Quicksand. And last time, not last time I talked to you, but the first time I had met you, you had just about joined this band, right?
Yeah, about a month previous to that.
So it's been about a year right now since you've been in the band?
About a year and a week.
And in that year, how much time have you had off?
What was that?
See, it seems to me like this is White Zombie, this is work, because it seems to me like, you know, the record has been doing so well, and then, okay, well, we finished playing out, you know, with Pantera, we played all these shows, and okay, now we're going to take a little time off and start to work on a new record, and then the record starts doing better and better and better, and it's like now you're out with Anthrax, and maybe after this, a solo tour?
No way, man. We want to tour
what do you
every
think?
Single band imaginable.
So right now they're out with Anthrax. Next time it might be Snow.
York.
I saw that Bjork video. Is that how to say it, Bjork?
Yeah,
she's cute. I didn't know anything about it. I just saw the video. And see, that's how I judge
you
my
don't
bands.
Know anything about it.
I don't
you
know anything about it.
You don't know it.
Hey, I work here. I don't watch it. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway, we're going to go to a commercial and find out more juicy stuff about White Zombie and how to say Bjork. Stay tuned. New York City with Sean and Jay from White Zombie, the most interviewed band on Headbangers Ball ever. So anyway, you've been playing a lot of shows, no time off. Do you think that you're going to be having time off soon to start recording new stuff? Never. I mean, have you even began to write anything new?
Yeah, we actually have almost the whole record written. We have at least 11 good songs, so we've been playing 2 of them live each night.
Oh, what are those songs that you're playing live?
Well, there's Feed the Gods, which is the song that's going to be in the Airheads movie. And then there's I Am Hell, which is going to be in the Beavis and Butthead record.
Beavis and Butthead are putting out a record?
Yeah. If you haven't had enough of those little guys, there's going to be a Beavis and Butthead record in a couple of months.
And it doesn't hurt that I'm jealous of two cartoon characters.
I think there should be a Ricky Rackman record.
There you go. It would probably sound just like the Beavis and Butthead record anyway. Now, where do you find the time to start writing new stuff? I mean, honestly, you're one of the hardest working bands in show business.
Hey, babe.
I don't know, man. We wrote a lot of riffs while we were on the road for the past year. And we had, like, about a month and a half off before this tour and Anthrax. And it's been, like, whatever. During that month and a half, we kind of put all the riffs together and wrote some songs, but
it was a solid month and a half of screaming at each other.
Yeah.
But, you know, songs.
And
like
is
that.
That where you get your inspiration?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Of such evil thoughts.
You gotta suffer for your art, babe.
And you're doing a lot of suffering right now, right?
Oh,
limos.
Yeah. Yeah, I've only been hanging out with, like, Pantera and Anthrax and tour buses all year. I'm suffering hard.
You hate it. Well, we're gonna be back with more from Roseland as the Headbangers Ball continues. See you in a little bit. Stay tuned. We're gonna go hang out with Anthrax at a gym. Whoopee! Got one question. And this is bitter, because I was supposed to be in this movie called Airheads. And once again, another thing that I got shut out of. But I'm not bitter. But you guys are in the movie. So tell me about this, the movie Airheads that's coming out that I'm not in.
It's gonna be awesome. Adam Sandler's in it. The other guy from Saturday Night Live, you know, the fat one, the really funny fat one. Kramer's in it. It's gonna be awesome. Now, story about this band, basically.
I know exactly. I read the script for it, and I'm still not in it. So tell me, what do you do in the band? I mean, in the band. What do you do in the movie? And what do you do in the band? But what do you do in the movie Airheads?
We're gonna be. I guess there's a club scene. I haven't read the script yet, but there is a club scene.
There's like a battle of the bands or something. Yeah.
That's not what we're doing, is it?
Yeah. Aren't we part of that?
I have no idea. We're gonna be in a club.
Okay. Well, maybe you guys are doing something. So obviously you haven't done it yet.
Right.
No, we're gonna during this tour. We're gonna fly over there.
Are any like big new things being offered to White Zombie now that you're all successful and everything? Other than that guy, how you doing? He's a keyboard player in White Zombie. You know when they hear that, he's the one that does the screaming in White Zombie. That's him. Doesn't look like that.
It was me. It's not me.
You know what? I knew it was him. I saw him and I go, you're in White Zombie. And he went up and he goes, yeah. And I go, you're the guy that goes, ah. And see that? I knew that kind of stuff. So any other kind of big offers come up? Like, you know, Tonight Show, Arsenio.
No.
Car wash openings.
Not yet. There's some cool stuff, though. Can we talk about the,
Should go right ahead.
Talk about
we're doing the Sabbath thing, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, guess what? You're not doing it because they're not going to do it.
Yeah, right.
Huh?
Are you serious?
I'm very, very serious.
Okay, never mind. Forget the whole thing.
I hate to be the bear. Are you talking about Sabbath with Ozzy?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Go ahead. There's a tribute record coming out that we're going to be on. It's going to be cool. Sepultura's on it. Megadeth's on it. Ministry's on it. Pantera's on it. We're on it. It's going to be awesome.
That's very cool.
Very cool.
I'm going to be on the Germs tribute record. You end up doing Sabbath, I do the Germs tribute record.
I love the Germs.
I don't know, we'll talk about that later. It's not important. Okay, so you're going to be on a Sabbath tribute record. That's very cool. What song are you going to do? See, now that I can hear.
Okay, we're doing Children of the Grave.
That's awesome. Any other, what would be another great tribute record? What about the Kiss tribute record? I mean, you've always done Kiss songs.
Yeah, I don't know. Whatever, no one approached us about it.
See that?
Oh, well.
I know what it's like. Like the Airheads movie. And I'm not in.
We're sorry.
We'll be back with more Headbangers Ball. And all jokes aside, this is obviously when you're playing in front of crowds, I mean, the crowds are getting bigger and a lot more people know the stuff now. I mean, because of Beavis and Butt-head. And is it kind of weird that
it
so many people watch?
To do with you, man.
Is it weird that so many people watch that?
Cartoon.
You know what? So many people, and the fact is, they're watching it and they don't realize that Beavis and Butthead is a comedy. They think they're seeing a mirror of their own selves, and they don't even realize it's a joke. But tell me, I mean, a lot more people. I mean, the record's been out 17 months or something, and now it feels like it's getting bigger and bigger, doesn't it?
It feels like it. It's getting larger, heavier, fatter.
More rotund.
You know, it's not called fat, it's called success. It's called success. I've been feeling quite successful lately.
Watch tonight when we play. We're going to go Beavis and Buttheads. The kids will cheer. Then we'll go.
Do me a favor. Don't do it. Don't do it. I know what happens when they say it. Be a friend. Don't do it. Anyways, right now we're going to play a video from these guys that I have pinstripes on my back fender of my motorcycle. They saw my motorcycle. Blatantly ripped it off again.
Man,
see these guys?
A little scooter.
Far from being a scooter, my friend.
Moto Guzzi.
Exactly. It says Schwinn, and then it says Black Sunshine. It says Black Schwinn.
It's got a purple banana.
It says Orange Crate. Orange Crate.
You put a little baseball card on the
table. Yeah, let's let them last month. More ragging. Keep on going. Keep on going. Here's White Zombie, Black Sunshine.
Ricky Rackman here. It's special Tuesday night edition of the Headbangers Ball. Inside this tiny club called the Viper Room, we are going to have a party for the movie Airheads. You're going to meet cast members, and White Zombie's going to play, and you are there. Tuesday edition of the Headbangers Ball for the movie Airheads. We had a contest. We have a winner. Our winner's name is?
Krista Bobick.
And you're from?
Denver, Colorado.
And you called up how many times to win this contest?
I called 67 times.
So you're doing this. The thing is, she got to go out to L.A., got to hang out in L.A., go to all these places. She's going to meet cast members and band members. And the down part is you have to co-host a show with me. And already I'm seeing that you got it down because you're like, how's it at? How's it at? You got the whole animated thing going on.
It's the media
right
savvy.
So any questions, since you are going to be the co-host for the night, any questions you want to ask? So just don't you know, I've been on MTV now for 5 years, and primetime night tonight, I've probably been on primetime now 3 times. So I've been here for 5 years, I've been on primetime 3 times, so maybe I'm not the right one to ask for tips, but anything you'd like to know since you are the co-host tonight?
Oh, God, I don't even know.
Big celebrity.
Is there anything we can't do?
What? That I'll tell you about later, but look, there's big celebrities here. See right there?
Ooh, Ted Jen Nelson. Ooh.
Chris Farley,
ooh.
Adam Sandler, people from
oh,
the movie.
Oh, yeah.
Who's the most famous person you've ever met before this night?
The guys from Metallica.
Well, woo! I don't know if they're going to be here tonight, but White Zombie is. We'll hook up with them. And right now, here is your DJing debut. You're going to intro a video for us, so go right ahead.
From the soundtrack of Airheads, it is Feed the Gods from White Zombie.
At the Viper Room, or so it's been called. With not only a couple cast members from the movie Airheads, but our winner, Krista Bobick. She gets to be a co-host, so co-host.
I'm co-hosting.
Yes, ask these guys questions.
Okay, all right. So, tell me, Chris, let's hear about the character that you play in your movie.
Krista, that's not fair.
That's a co-hosting.
My nose!
Krista, you're doing a fine job, darling.
Thank you.
My character in Airheads is on many levels. I play a rookie cop. Well, he's not a rookie cop. There's much more to it than that. No, he's just a rookie cop.
And what about you, Adam? You're basically one of the Airheads or one of the guys in the band.
I'm the drummer in the band, and I guess I'm also a rookie cop. I don't know.
So go ahead, do some co-hosting. Ask some questions.
Do some co-hosting. Okay. So the question is, all right, you guys, you're doing the music thing in the movie. So who would be your favorite band on the soundtrack?
Strike three, baby! No, Angie! Please, Angie, don't do this!
See, that's the other thing. There's one thing you have to understand. There's certain questions that just strike a nerve with our guests.
So.
And you found that. It took you one day. You found that nerve. And I should have gave you the warning.
Don't get him upset.
I'm trying to hang out and have a good time.
She's okay. She's going to be okay.
Everybody's having a good time except you, baby.
She's doing good, Angie. Please. It's okay. It's cool.
We're going to try to calm him down and get Adam back. We'll be back with more Headbangers Ball, the Airheads edition.
All right, listen. This is the greatest band in America, and their name is White Zombie!
Is everybody okay in there?
He wants to know what your demands are for releasing the hostages.
What's he mean by hostages?
What are your demands?
I don't want anything. I just don't want to go outside.
Headbangers Ball, we're here with Rob and a new drummer of White Zombie who we're going to have Rob introduce you to in a little bit, but we also wanted to remind you, this is Krista Bobick who won the contest and is also the co-host. You having a good time?
I am having a great time.
Really?
Heck yeah.
And you also said earlier that you were a big White Zombie fan.
Oh yeah, most
definitely.
You've
seen White Zombie play before?
Uh-huh.
You ever seen him play in a club this small?
God, no. I've never even been in a club this small.
All right, well.
I have no idea.
Okay. Now, first of all, if you've watched the Headbangers Ball, I mentioned this before, you might know who this guy is, but introduce this new drummer type.
Johnny Sticks. Sticks of Thunder from
Isn't that with umlauts over the eye?
Yeah, you might recognize him from Poison. Used to be in Poison. Man, I mean, I warrant.
And he also played that programming for Flock of Seagulls. He was great in that. And John, who last time we hooked up you were in Testament.
Right.
Before that, Exodus.
Exodus.
Before that, carried the drums for
Anthrax.
And before that, you sold burritos at a well-known Mexican establishment.
If you don't say,
man, slut, jumps the ship. What do you see?
Yeah. I'm the ship jumper. We'll be jumping up
soon.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
So you got to be in the movie. I mean, was this pretty cool or?
Pretty cool.
Was there a big difference between doing this movie and doing like videos?
Well, yeah, because since Chris Farley had to be talking, we couldn't have any playback, so we had to jump around to nothing. So that's why everyone's jumping around looking stupid, because there was no music. We had to pretend.
See yourself doing any?
Nothing.
Do you see yourself doing any acting in the future?
No.
What about you?
No.
You've got a face. You could be like actor guy.
Yeah, you know, I've been in a couple of movies, but I don't want to mention.
Yeah, but those are the type of movies that we really don't show on, except those very late night pay channels.
Let's keep that quiet.
Let's tell you were good in that one, so I've heard. Well, we're gonna come back. What was that? We'll have to talk about that. That's like blackmail material. Anything else you wanted to ask some co-hosts?
Oh, what's going on right now? Are you guys on the road? Or are you?
Well, this is really hard, but
I don't know.
We're just getting ready to do this show. That's about it. You know, we prepared for like 2 months to do this show. You know, big long set.
We're gonna play a video now, and then we're gonna come back to the Airheads party. This is the Headbangers Ball, and right now here is Offspring with "Come Out and Play." Say it right.
Yep, that's it.
And we're here with Jay and Sean from White Zombie.
Doing the punk out. Are you like
No, it's Kaja Gugu.
Are you Devo?
We went through that. It's Kaja Gugu. A little
you're
bit of hair.
The punk out.
It's a little
like
bit of
doing
haircut.
The
100. Little haircut. 100. Now you ask some questions. You're being co-host now. You won.
That's right.
Co-host for the night. So ask White Zombie some questions. Shay and John.
Okay. The question is right now.
John.
What? Exactly.
That was close enough. Yeah.
See, I was just trying to see if she caught it.
What is going on with you guys? I mean, what's going to be coming up?
Go ahead.
Oh, gee. No, we're working on a new record right now. Probably be out in like January.
Very cool.
And you were also in the movie Airheads, right?
Yeah.
Acting.
Not acting. It was like making.
Who did you play in the movie?
Well, it's just us, like, playing it. Well, first of all, they pan across the whiskey sign that says Death Fest, White Zombie.
Yeah,
and then it's us playing inside, and there's all these big, like, Phil and Selmo guys, like, moshing and stuff. It's pretty funny. But it was just, like, making a music video. It's
so
just
So you playing live and having a bunch of people, like, moshing in a pit, that was pretty out of character for a usual White Zombie show, right?
Oh, yeah. Usually everyone's seated and very polite and a little bit of the...
Having a cocktail, you know, kind of like the Partridge Family shows, that's our new thing. You know, like family entertainment, you know, for the heartland of America.
Could I be Reuben Kincaid?
Oh, hell yeah.
Okay, I'm Reuben.
You are Reuben.
And you?
We're going to travel with
Shirley.
I'm Shirley. I don't want to be Shirley. No.
You want to be Lori?
I want to be Lori.
You're Lori.
Lori would be good. Yeah. All right.
I always wanted to be the one kid that was the drummer that disappeared and then they got ended up with a blonde drummer. I was that first guy. We'll be back with more Headbangers Ball, Airhead Edition. It's the Headbangers Ball Airheads edition. Ricky Rackman here with Krista Bobic, Judd Nelson, who's in the movie Airheads, Nina
Shamashko,
who I let her pronounce. Did she pronounce it right, Judd?
I pronounced my own name right.
See, I let her pronounce her name because I know that there was another VJ whose name I don't want to say, Duff, and so we'll say let her pronounce it. And also, you told me before we rolled that there was something of mine that you have always wanted to hold. So I'm giving you now. You said you always wanted to hold the mic.
No, that wasn't it.
Wasn't the microphone?
It was.
You were gonna ask her. Chris is our co-host. You be co-host. To ask some questions. Get
okay.
Me out of this.
Yes, I have a question.
Nina calls it Mr. Mike.
Oh, Mr.
So
Mike.
It's the same difference from that.
Okay.
Okay. The question here is, all right, as actors, Okay, what was it like working with musicians in the movie? What happened? Was it a party? You know.
I never really saw the musicians. You know, I would be sort of pulled out of a really dark room, and they would make me say one or two words, and then push me back into the dark room. I didn't even know it was a movie about a radio station.
Yeah, I'm completely unaware that there was any music whatsoever. I mean, isn't this a romantic comedy or that's
a drama? A drama.
Well, you know what? The question I have is, you're such a big, successful movie star, why can't you buy a decent t-shirt? You got a holes in it and everything? What is that? We supposed to feel sorry for you? He's got a holes in his shirt. He's got a dirty shirt on.
No, actually, you know, this is the Headbangers Ball.
Exactly.
Okay, so I don't care what anyone else says or what anyone else does.
You're crazy.
I am a headbanger, and that's why I'm a football fan, because that's headbanging. And that's why I'm a Raiders fan.
Oh, I know, she's from Denver.
And the Denver Broncos are a nice team, but it's pretty hard to root for a team that wears orange.
Blue. And they suck.
We're big football fans at these parts, let me tell you. We're going to play a video from a band right now that is going to be playing Woodstock this Saturday, and I will be there. Really? I didn't think so. Are you really going to be there?
Yes.
You're liars. You're liars. I will be. You'll be there. Stay tuned. Much more. This is Nine Inch Nails.
Hi, welcome back to Headbangers Ball, and I am Krista Bobic.
That's the video we just saw first.
I don't know what video you
Oh, it was the Beastie Boys Sabotage. Weren't you paying attention? You like the Beastie Boys?
I love the Beastie Boys.
Okay. Woohoo! Now, you suck.
Okay, and right now we are sitting here with David Arquette and Amy Locaine and Ricky, of course. And let's see here.
Ask him a question.
Yeah, we want to know. Who were you in the movie?
My name was Ron Carter in the movie, and I'm a big Beastie Boy fan.
What type of music are you listening to right now?
I usually like alternative music.
Like what?
Alternative music.
Alternative music? Like what? Have you ever been a rock star's girlfriend? Be honest.
No, I'm
You never... play a rock star's girlfriend in the movie. Have you ever been a rock star's girlfriend?
No, I've never been a rock star's girlfriend in real life.
If you were, what rock star's girlfriend would you want to be?
I don't know. I can't think of anyone right now.
Come on now.
If I wanted to be a rock star's girlfriend, I'd be one.
What rock star's girlfriend would you want to be, David?
I want to be Sly Stone's girlfriend.
Really? I have some strings. I might be able to try to pull that for you.
Thank you, Rick.
We'll work on that.
I appreciate
we'll
that.
We'll work on that.
Thanks.
One.
Could you?
What about you? What rock star's girlfriend would you like to be?
I don't know. That's a tie. I have two different ones, and they're totally one end of the spectrum to the other. We have Peter. What is it? Peter Klett. I think that's his name, from Candlebox, the guitarist.
Yeah, you really care.
And. Okay, Dimebag Daryl from Pantera.
Riveting, two totally, truly romantic type guys. And of course, here we have Amy, who has never been a rock star's girlfriend. But would. Like that.
Hey.
Did you say Ron Wood? Because I think I saw her hanging out with him one night.
Okay, the dirt will fly. We'll be back. More Headbangers Ball.
Ron Wood is.
Ow.
This special edition of MTV's Headbangers Ball is brought to you by Airheads, the new comedy from 20th Century Fox, now playing at theaters everywhere.
Everybody having a good time tonight!
20th Century Fox invites you,
even though you're a goon,
to live it up. With
the Lone Rangers? There's three of you. You're not exactly lone.
No idea what you're saying right now.
So grab a ticket.
I know the procedure.
Cancel your plans.
Oh boy, I made an appointment with my proctologist.
And join the party.
I don't want anything. I just don't want to go outside.
Airheads, rated PG-13. Now playing at theaters everywhere.
The Lone Rangers?
What's wrong with that?
Well, there's three of you. You're not exactly lone.
No idea what you're saying right now.
Welcome back to Headbangers Ball, Airheads Edition, and Ricky and I are here with Tom Arnold. And Chris Farley here from Airheads.
Tom Arnold isn't even in the movie Airheads, but because he's in such another huge movie right now, we figure let's just try to suck in as many viewers as we can. So congratulations with that.
Thank you very much. It's going very well, and I hope Airheads does well. They're in the same studio.
Have you seen the movie yet?
Yeah, True Lies. I saw it at the premiere. And you mean Airheads? It's a great movie. I haven't seen it, of course. But I know it's good because Farley's in it. And, my God! Woman?
Roger. I just want to tell you, just so you know, these guys were sitting here comfortable. They had about, three or four girls on each arm.
Rod,
and then we
everywhere.
Say, hey, come up here and talk about the movies,
right,
which is already doing huge, so you don't have to... But we can talk about their movies.
Yeah.
We can talk about True Lies.
True Lies is going very well. It was great to be in it, but I'm excited about Chris's movie and Chris's girlfriend, who keeps reaching
between
here.
Yeah, she's a funny gal. He's my girlfriend, Christy Scott. She only hangs around with me because she says that, well, I make her laugh sometimes with funny faces. Look at this.
We'll be back with more. From the movie Airheads, and who was with Lemmy in that video?
That was Whitfield Crane from Ugly Kid Joe. Woo, woo, woo. And Ice-T.
Why don't you give Ice-T? Okay, and Ice-T.
Woo, woo, woo. Woo,
woo. Is that a Denver thing? The woo, woo?
Denver? No, I don't
know. So you did good. You're a co-host. I mean, you had the BJ thing down. It took me 5 years to like...
Hey, no, you gave me pointers, though. Okay. You did give me pointers.
Sit here for Chris, our co-host on Headbangers. So you had a good time? You got to meet everybody?
Heck yeah.
Any memories to bring back to Denver?
Oh, yeah.
Anything you can talk about?
The water being shot in the eye, that was great. Tom Arnold.
You like Tom?
Tom Arnold, yeah.
And of course, you should mention some of the people in Airheads, since Airheads
were
nice enough
Adam
to pay
Sandler.
For this whole thing.
Adam Sandler was awesome.
So thank the
MTV
people from Airheads.
Great. Yep. I'd like to thank everyone from Airheads.
Thank MTV.
And MTV, yes.
And all the people that put this thing on. Thank
That's
you,
right.
Pam. Very nice.
And yes, thank you.
You had fun. You had fun.
Yes,
you did a great job. And congratulations.
Thanks.
Didn't you also get some money for this?
Yes, I got $5,000.
Did you spend it yet?
No, I only spent $1,000 of it.
How much time you got here?
Till tomorrow.
I know how you can kill $4,000 in a couple hours. Be back Saturday. Hey, we're going to be in Woodstock. And
Woo!
For $4,000, I know a way you could get to Woodstock. So we'll talk about that. Thanks a lot, for everybody. Glad that you spent the evening with us. This Saturday, I'll be at Woodstock, and I hope you will, too. And from the Viper Room in Hollywood, California, with these ugly people, good night.
Beavis and Butt-head, rock your world next. Stay tuned.
Super rock. To me, I associate that. It sounds like the Scorpions. It sounds like a 90. Like 93 metal show. This is super rock.
Super rock.
Rob?
Yo, hey, hello.
How you doing today?
I'm all right.
Here at the Limelight?
Yep.
Does the Limelight have any special history for you?
No, none whatsoever.
What was the first concert you ever went to?
I saw Steve Martin. When he toured for his Wild and Crazy Guy record.
Really?
Yeah, like totally. He came out in an Egyptian outfit with this huge mirror guitar, played King Tut.
No way.
That was the first show I ever saw. It was only five dollarinis. Five donuts.
Was that in Massachusetts?
Yeah, I was in Boston at some like...
What was your first real rock show? Not to diss.
I actually saw, I think I saw The Police with the Go-Go's.
Really?
At Boston Garden. Me and my brother were really little. And there was a bunch of like older kids like burning holes in their jackets with their cigarettes. We're like, what's so fun about this? Yeah, this sucks.
You have a comic book coming out on Marvel. I foolishly went around the city trying to buy it because someone told me it was out, only to be told today by you that it's just...
It's completely sold out everywhere.
Yeah.
You can't find a copy.
Well, no, but that's what they told me.
Try and find a copy. It's not possible. For some reason, you know, I started talking to Marvel about doing a comic, and overnight it turned into like the thing existed and it was on sale, and I think
and sold out.
Yeah, it's sold out. People said they've been trying to order it for a year, and it just doesn't even exist. It's totally still in the planning stages. So
there's not much you can tell me. Do you have ideas of what's it going to be called?
I mean, it'll probably it's not going to be like a comic with the band as superheroes running around, fighting crime or something. Although that could be good. It'll just be like, a whole bunch of different short stories with like maybe characters pulled out of songs, and I'm sure.
So will it be about the band?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, who cares about that? Basically, it was a big scam for me to work with a bunch of artists I really liked. And, it was kind of cool to write a story and give it to some guy whose comics I've been reading since I was a little kid.
This video, More Human Than Human. I was checking it out a bit this week.
You checked the... scan the video?
I scanned the video on numerous occasions, might I say. I know that this is the first video that you fully had control of directing.
Yeah. What do you think of that? I always think that in order for it to be real, that the band should have complete control over everything. Because you can always hire a team of incredibly talented people to package you and dress you up and present you, but whether it's from the stage show to the artwork, the album cover, the t-shirts, the videos, I just think even if they're not as slick, that the band should always handle it, just because then it's 100% White Zombie. And I think the kids know, because they can tell, because it doesn't have that, if you hire the hip video guy of the month,
Right, and then 3 months later when your video's on, it looks really dated.
Yeah, and all the videos have that, insert band name here look to them, it could be any band.
Right.
I'd rather have a lesser quality product that is truly a White Zombie thing than your typical, slick package deal.
Now, was the Super 8 footage, was that from your childhood?
Yeah.
It was?
Yeah, it was. That was, the inspiration, because my mom sent me all the Super 8 stuff, and I was watching it.
I love Super 8.
And it was so bizarre that I was like, this is a video right here.
That was
here.
You and your brother,
around. And a bunch of, I think they're my cousins or something, I don't know. It just seemed to be endless hours of footage of little kids pulling their ears and sticking their tongues out. That was the thing to do at the moment. But I mean, just the stuff like the monkey with the beetle wig playing guitar, that was something my dad filmed in 1966. I guess the Beatles were a big joke or something to people. And I was just like, this is so weird. Get kicked out of a band.
Open his mouth?
To say, why don't we try some of my songs?
2 years with that, really, that metal supposedly died. It's also coincided completely with you guys' success. So, how do you figure that? How does that, theory on that?
I don't really think metal died. I think what happened is a lot of the bands, got really comfortable with what they were doing. We can do the same thing forever, and everyone's always going to love us. And kids just get bored. And I think what happened was, once kids saw Ministry or Nine Inch Nails, they're like, hey, this is just as heavy as those metal bands, except it's 10 times more interesting.
Right.
So their focus just shifted, because it's not like, there was some plague and every metal kid dropped dead someday or something.
I think a lot of them are still alive.
Yeah, I think they just get bored, because I know, there was a lot of bands I used to really like, and I'll go see them, and I'm like, God, I used to remember this is a really intense show, and this just seems like a bunch of old farts going through the motions beyond belief. And I think a lot of other kids picked up on that really fast.
Where's the new album?
In Hollywood. We recorded at some studio where they only make rap records.
How many months were you in there going in there every day?
We went in there every day for at least 3 months straight.
Wow.
And then pretended that we had enough material to make a record, moved to a recording studio. I think it was the pressure of that sort of
you're
wasting $1,000 a day that made us really snap into writing mode, because we could see the money flying out the window.
The magic carpet.
So that's when we really wrote all the songs.
Was writing with a good drummer? I mean, supposedly you're really happy with him as a drummer.
Yeah, I mean, that really
made all the songwriting
easier. Yeah, we've never had a good drummer, so we didn't really know.
Right.
And then to have a good drummer, whoa, I didn't even know anyone could do that,
So did that help in the songwriting process?
It was perfect, because he would just play. He's like the human drum machine. He'll just sit there and play the same beat for 8 hours and never even say anything.
Really?
Whereas most drummers,
they're just busy,
whiny. They complain. They just whine about everything. Oh, this is no fun. I want to play something where I can show off and get girls.
This band is cool.
Next, one from the Kings of Goth, some House of Pain, and some soul-searching with Rob Zombie when Super Rock continues.
Super Rock, to search for one grand prize-winning band to open for them sometime during their upcoming U.S. tour in support of their new release, Astro Creep 2000, songs of love, destruction, and other synthetic delusions of the electric head.
And the gig pays $5,000.
Way more than I usually get.
To enter, send a VHS tape or audio cassette of your band performing three or more original or cover songs.
Along with a mugshot so we can see exactly what we're getting ourselves into.
Include your name, age, address, and phone number and send it to MTV's Warm Up the Zombie Contest. Care of Geffen Records Video, 9130 Sunset Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90069. Hang with the band, open the show, flash backstage passes.
Eat bad food and lie to your friends that you put them on the guest list.
What young bands do you plan to take on tour to sort of give them exposure the way other bands did for you?
Well, it's funny you should ask. We're having a super rock contest.
Wait, the contest?
Man, that's so
good thing you mentioned.
That's such perfect timing, this contest, right when you asked that question.
Now, I believe the contest is called, because I know a little bit about it myself, it's called Warming Up the Zombie.
Right. It should be called Play in Front of White Zombie and Have Kids Throw Stuff at You.
Is that...
But that really wasn't that catchy.
Yeah.
No, we're gonna have kids, in theory. I don't know if anyone's going to do it. You know, you can mail in videotapes. Well, I know they will do it because you get $5,000 if we pick your tape, so that's...
Really?
That's enough motivation to do anything.
Will the band be the decider of...
Yeah, we get to look at the tapes and pick the band that we want to open up for us on tour. Well, just for the show when we hit that town.
Do you think when you're choosing the band to open, to warm up for the zombie, are you going to try to pick a band that's similar to you? Or are you going to try to do a band a favor that you think really needs a break? Or are you just going to have a big laugh?
I think I'll probably just...
This is Black Sunshine.
Coming up on Super Rock, Rob Zombie reveals his secrets in the rock and roll church and a video for one of the greatest bands of all time, Cheap Trick. So don't go away.
I think a big part of you guys' success story is just the fact that you were on tour for so long and you just played and played and played until, you know, I mean, I always believe that that's a way to really sort of get successful. Do you think now that you've sort of technically made it, are you still going to have that type of grueling tour schedule, or are you going to like just sit back?
Well, I mean, we'll probably tour as long, just not as many times in each city,
right?
Because on that tour it went from like bars to little clubs to halls to like hockey arenas,
right?
And stuff. So, you know,
like in the
I don't think
two
we're going to do that whole progression
every,
again, hopefully.
Every venue in a city.
Maybe this show will go from hockey arenas to halls to bars to
right.
Work our way backwards. But no, I mean, I think the touring was what made it. I mean, all the other things like radio and video and everything helped, but the tour is what cemented it as like,
yeah.
Oh, this isn't a fluke because enough kids.
Right.
You know, I mean, it seems like every kid who bought the record eventually came to the show. I mean, because we'd play like Chicago for the eighth time and it'd be
right.
Like, why are there more kids again? You know,
right.
Aren't they sick of this? But, you know, I figured like every time we'd leave a city, by the time we'd come back around again, I'd be like, we've just sold enough records in the last week to sell out that place again with just kids who bought it in the last
in
week. So it was like,
right.
You know, I think it was always new kids. I don't know if it's violence or just clumsiness. People are always getting hurt.
They're lacking
like,
in
so
grace, the White Zombie fans.
There's always like, you know, you walk off stage and there's like four ambulances and...
Really?
You know, it's just like, what happened, you know?
Yeah.
Well, kids seem to have this new notion that their necks are made of iron.
Yeah.
I can jump 20 feet, land on my head on cement, and walk away and do it again.